Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 2.1, Problem 5. This is Section 2.1, Problem number 5. It says, consider the data shown below, which is a summary of the blood type of 50 different randomly selected BCC students. And you have a chart here where it has a different blood type. There's a lot of them that say blood type O, blood type A, there's blood type B, there's blood type AB. So it's, you know, just 50 students, what blood type do they have? Part A says, create a frequency table for this data. So our frequency table, what we're going to do is make a little chart, and we'll have blood type and then frequency. So one blood type that shows up pretty frequently is O. A shows up pretty frequently. B is in there. AB is in there. And that's it for our chart. So now what we have to do is systematically go through and count the number of occurrences of each blood type. So count carefully. Blood type O. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Blood type O showed up 22 times. So that would be the frequency. So the next one we have listed is A. So again, systematically go through and count how many occurrences of blood type A. Take your time, be careful. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. There are 18 occurrences of blood type A, so that will be the frequency, 18. Blood type B. How many occurrences of blood type B did we have? Same process, go through and count them. Top row, I don't have any, but then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I guess that was the last one, so there was 6. And finally, blood type AB. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. So that's a frequency table for the different blood types for the 50 students in our survey. And it's not a bad check. You know this 50, the little table given, we have 10 rows of 5 columns, so 50. Add up the frequencies. If it adds up to 50, it's a good indication that you probably counted right. It's not a guarantee. You may have made two mistakes that canceled each other out. But if it does not add up to 50, then you surely made a mistake. You either missed something or double counted it. So 22 and 18 is 40. 40 plus 6 is 46. 46 plus 4 is 50. So that's a good sign. It's good to check that. So, there's our frequency table for part A. B asks us to draw a bar graph for the data. So, again, our bars must be labeled. It must have a clearly labeled number scale. The bars can be drawn horizontally or vertically, and they should not touch. There should be a space in between them. Now, we have more space going side to side. It's more traditional. I like drawing the bars vertically, but a horizontal bar graph would fit a little bit nicer on the space I have available on the whiteboard. So, I'm going to go horizontally. So I'll run my number scale along the bottom. Now again, determine your number scale by the biggest bar that you're going to have to deal with, which will be the bar for blood type O. It's going to go up to 22. You could even go 22 little lines. That's not too bad. If you go two at a time, you'd need 11 lines. Five at a time, you'd need 5 lines to 25. I'll probably go two at a time, because usually I like to have about 10 lines. 11 is close enough. And again, you don't have to do it a certain way. As long as you label it, it's okay. So if I'm going to go two at a time. I'm going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And that's far enough. And going two at a time, they would get labeled 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22. This one is kind of close, whether I'd want to go two at a time or five at a time. As long as it's labeled, it's okay. So the first bar for blood type O goes out to 22. So it's 22 on my number scale. Blood type O. The next blood type A goes out to 18. I do have an 18 on my number scale. Notice my bars don't touch. I label the bar, it's A, and you can label it at the left edge also if you like, or right on the bar. The next one, blood type B, is going to go up to 6. I have 6 on my number scale. And finally, the last one, blood type AB, goes up to 4. I have 4 on my number scale. Again, the bars don't touch. It's nice if we give the bar graph a name, so we'll say, it's right off to the side. Blood type 450. BCC students. And notice, coincidentally, it is a Pareto. The bars go from big to small. So that was B. Draw a bar graph. We have a bar graph. And this one did go horizontally, which is okay. Part C, do you feel that a pie chart would be appropriate for this data? Yes. Because you're not going to have a student with two different blood types at the same time. You wouldn't have that situation where you have two different categories simultaneously. So a pie chart would work out very well for this data.